The unique challenges that P&G have are that we make everyday products, and really, people don't think about our brands very much. What TV affords us to do is keep the mental availability of our brands on people's minds, and therefore, the brands grow. And even now, as we're moving into emerging markets, the majority of our media still rests in TV, but we just need to use it more strategically.
For big brands, there isn't a substitute. And I think it remains the place to make an announcement to the world. It remains the place to make an emotional connection with customers. Certainly, it's interesting to see the way people race online from the first sight of a TV ad. A lot of that's got to do with the fact that, as I say, in retail, urgency is the great driver.
You know, 5 years ago, if I'd got up at an advertising conference and said, you know, BBH firmly believe in the power of television, it's central to our media strategy, I'd have been laughed off the stage. But what we've actually understood over the last maybe 5 or so years is that actually this is television's golden age. So if you're a manufacturer, if you're a brand, you've got to grow your audience. So broadcast is fundamentally important. But I think the way you buy television, the way you use television has got to change. So what we do is we create a piece of advertising, we create not just a commercial, we create an event. It commands attention, commands an audience. And then what happens, it starts a conversation. That conversation goes into social networking. And we've had a huge amount of success with this. If you look at the work we've done for Yo Valley, we did this sort of big first in break on X Factor, and more people were tweeting about the Yo Valley commercial than they were X Factor for about 13, 14 hours, which is fairly remarkable. They saw an immediate uptake in sales. And if you're a marketeer, that's what you want. You know, you've got this yogurt coming out of a factory. You know, I've got to sell it. You know, it's got a shelf life. That's what advertising does. And that's what television delivers better than anybody else.
We see, literally, when we take TV off the air, our brands go down. When we put it back on the air, our brands go up. So there's such a tight correlation with TV advertising and growth. The Olympics, for example, we ended up doubling the average return on investment. We created a commercial called The Best Job, and it was 2 minutes. And we used it on TV, and we used it online. And TV was actually a great ignition point because we knew we could get mass awareness. It had a huge spike. Then people started sharing this ad everywhere. And so it just kept growing and growing and growing. Literally 76 billion impressions, almost so staggering, we're not even sure what it means. And that was because we combined the power of TV with online, with conversations with consumers.
We're starting to see people watching certain TV shows in extraordinary numbers. And it's a matter of being in the right place at the right time, not just because people are watching, but because the atmosphere is right, the context is right. The Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday fresh food campaign for Woolworths supermarkets had an enormous impact. The campaign was launched around the final of a TV program we were sponsoring, The Voice, and we ran that as a 2-minute spot in the middle of the program. There was no voiceover. There was a URL address at the end, but nothing else. And it worked. And really, TV has 99% of the credit for that. If TV advertisers got as excited about the number of people watching their TV ads as they do about the number of people tweeting about their brand, they'd be excited a lot of the time. I think our judgment is a little skewed at the moment because social is new. But the truth is, social media wasn't created for commercial interests. It was created for private interests. And that's largely what it serves.
So, you know, the history of television, the power it's created for brands is unprecedented, absolutely unprecedented. And I believe we'll go on being so. I don't see that diminishing. I see it actually increasing if you link all of the new media together, still create ideas that engage your audience, inspire your audience. You can go on doing great work.
I think many of the innovations that we're coming up with that are TV combined with the digital means are going to come together closer and closer, and they'll become one. And we won't distinguish TV from digital anymore. It'll just be content and communications and engagement with consumers. Because at the core of success is the idea. So one of the things I've observed in the last several years is we have fallen in love with technologies. We need to fall back in love with the ideas. So that's really what the future of marketing will be all about, and TV will play a huge role in that.